Hi, welcome back everyone. Today I am going to discuss the most important concept of true versus false lumen in IoT section. How to differentiate a true lumen from false lumen. So initially we shall have a brief idea on what is aiotic dissection. This is the normal iota, intima, media and adventitia. And you can see there is a rent or tear in the intima and the blood flows into this media creating a false lumen. And the differential diagnosis includes for this is the intramural hematoma. There is no rent but there is a hematoma within the media of the vessels. So this is again diagrammatic representation of the same. You can see the rent, you can see the blood flowing into the false lumen, and false lumen will increase in size, and this is the true lumen, this is the false lumen. This is the classic appearance of aortic dissection. So coming to the most important part of the video is differentiating the true from false lumen. So this is the axial CECT section. You can see there is a flap, that is the intimal flap, which is displaced. So which one is the true lumen and which one is the false lumen? So let us see how to differentiate them. So the most important thing about the true lumen, usually the true lumen is smaller in size. You can see here, this is the true lumen or this is the false lumen. This is the true lumen, which is slightly smaller in size. Often high contrast density, you can appreciate the contrast density here as well as here. This is the true lumen, this is the false lumen. You can see the false lumen, the contrast density is less. And usually the true lumen is compressed by the false lumen. You can see the false lumen is continuously going and compressing the true lumen. And once you see the dissection flap going till the branches of the aorta, the origin of the branches usually arise from the true lumen. So if you see the branch, suppose a celiac trunk or SMA, wherever it is communicating, that should be the true lumen. It's in most of the cases. And another important sign is the intimal calcium displacement sign. You can see here the intimal calcification, small speck of calcification, it's displaced, which should be located here. It has been displaced internally. This is called as intimal calcial displacement sign. So these are the characteristic features which we should look for to identify the true lumen. So let us see how to identify the false lumen. Usually the false lumen is larger in size. You can see the false lumen is usually larger in this image as well as in this image. You can see that this is the false lumen, this is the true lumen. And often low contrast density, which I've already explained, which is due to the delayed opacification of the contrast. And the beak sign and the cobweb sign and the presence of thrombus. Let us see about the beak sign later, and I'm going to explain the cobweb sign here. You can see the few strands or hypodense strands within the false lumen which are hanging to the displaced intimal layer. These are nothing but the residual ribbons of the media within the false lumen. So presence of this strands, which represents the appearance of cobweb, which is called as cobweb sign, helps in identification of false lumen. And once there is a thrombus, most of the times the thrombus forms in the false lumen because there is no continuous flow in the false lumen. There is a stasis of blood in the false lumen. So these are the features which help in identification of false lumen. So let us see the beak sign. This is an excellent illustration given in Radiopedia by Dr. Vincent Tatko. You can see the intimal flap, intimal calcium displacement, false lumen, true lumen. Here if you appreciate, the density of the false lumen contrast is less, and here the density is more. This is the true lumen, this is the false lumen, larger in size, smaller in size. And the important sign is the beak sign. Beak sign is nothing but acute angulation at the edge of the false lumen. You can see the acute angle here. So this is the acute angle. Once you find the acute angle, that's the false lumen. It's the most important sign, which is very much helpful in differentiating true from false lumen. So this is a summary slide, how to differentiate both of them, which is very easy now. As we have all seen, the false lumen is usually larger, low contrast density, beak sign, cobweb sign, and the presence of thrombus. So all these features together gives us the clue for the identification of false lumen. Why it's very important to differentiate the true and false lumen? Because it helps in the management, which lumen the surgeon has to enter to do a stent or an aortic repair. So we need to know which is the true lumen and which is the false lumen. And another important differential diagnosis which we should remember is the acute intramural aortic hematoma as well as the penetrating atherosclerotic ulcer. So these are the two differentials which are very important to keep in mind when there is an aortic dissection. So this is again diagrammatic representation of aortic dissection as well as acute intramural hematoma. You can see the intact intimal layer. So always try to see whether it is intact or not, whether it is progressing or not. Identify the signs of all the signs which I have already explained about the true and false lumens in case of aortic dissection. Thank you all.